AJA, I'm Colton.
And I'm Maria.
And this is APN for November 8th, 2024. Hey, Maria, what are the birthdays for this week?
The birthdays this week are Jackson W., Walker M., Addison P., McKenna M., Caden P., and Asher H. I hope they have a good birthday.
For lunch today, we have an Italian-style calzone, marinara sauce, green beans, mandarin oranges, and a milk.
Hey, Colton, do you know what today is?
No, what is it?
Parents.
Oh, Lord.
No, that's not how you use it.
Then how'd I use it?
You use the trowel like this. You know, to clean?
Oh, Jesus.
Really? All right.
Got this.
Power of Tim will be meeting at Mrs. Huber's room at 4 o'clock. By the way, on November 11th, the Veterans Day forms are due.
Both the boys and the girls have their first basketball scrimmage next Thursday. Both are at 5 p.m. against Hilliard Memorial. I don't know if I'll be there, but I sure hope you guys are. Today, the report cards have come out, and I repeat, the report cards have come out. This might be a code red for some people, but not for me, because I got straight A's, you know, because I'm the best. Grace at the Grace.
Well, this is our time. Have a great day, Jay.
Hey, staff and students, welcome to Friday. It is Friday, November 8th, 2024. Listen carefully, I have lots of important information to share with you. First of all, a reminder that today you received your printed report cards. This afternoon when you leave, we are going to contact all your families and let them know that your first quarter report card is coming home today so they can see that and remind them that grades are always accessible and available on Canvas and that if they can't log in with their information, they can always ask you to log in. So we'll be sharing that information with them. Also, today, an advisory, we are kicking off our PTO winter fundraiser. You're getting one of these forms. Inside are some beautiful things for you to sell. We have a lot of great items that you can choose from there. Basically, what we need is your help if this is something that you are interested in doing to help out our PTO to raise some funds. The money that is raised goes back to our students and teachers for things here at school. Sometimes it is games and activities. Sometimes it is food celebrations. PTO does a lot to support all of our students. So we know that it is a busy time of year for fundraising. If your family would like to participate, great. If your family would not like to participate and support PTO in other ways, that is absolutely fine too. No pressure from us. But there are a couple ways to do it. You can, your family can sell online. They have all received emailed information about that, or you can show this order form to them. Remember to sell to people that you know and trust, like your teachers, family, and friends. And the important dates are that this will wrap up in just about a week or so. We're not selling for very long because all of these will be in right before Thanksgiving. The pickup for the flowers is the day before Thanksgiving, the week before Thanksgiving break. So all that information is in there. You are getting both the order form and the flyer that tells about it. Please make sure those go home. We are also telling your family that those are coming home today. Let's talk about prizes for this. Any advisory class that has at least 7 students that sell any items will receive a donut celebration party. Any advisory class that has at least 7 students, even if those students only sell one item, will receive a donut celebration party. We have bigger advisories, so you can participate or not participate, but still be recognized and receive that reward as well. Also, for our top-selling 7th grader and our top-selling 8th grader, you get $100 in cash for you. For our 2nd place, $75, and 3rd place, $50 from our PTO. So lots of great things going on there with PTO and the fundraiser. Let's talk about next week. We have big things going on. On Monday, the next day of school, Monday, it is Veterans Day, one of the most important days that we celebrate here in our building. We will have our annual Veterans Day assembly on Monday morning. You have a modified schedule all day long. First of all, we invite all students and staff to wear red, white, and blue to honor our nation's veterans on Monday. Reminder, wear red, white, and blue on Monday. Second thing, this is a very special assembly. We have a group of teachers that have worked hard to put this together. We have a number of special performances and speakers coming in on Monday. We're excited to hear our 8th grade choir perform the national anthem. We have a guest speaker coming from Honor Flight. That is the same program that took Mr. Lack on his adventure earlier in the year. Mr. Lack is excited to be at the Veterans Day Assembly. And we will recognize him. We have some other guest speakers that will be presenting some other neat things throughout that assembly. So we'll talk more about expectations on Monday, but please know that as you are going into that assembly, we want your best behavior, we want your best attitude as we take time to recognize our nation's heroes. Also, next week during advisory, we are kicking off a very important topic in both 7th and 8th grade. In 8th grade, you'll be doing a program called Signs of Suicide. It is a focus on mental health and supporting students with mental health needs. It's very important that every kid hears this message and that we take that serious. We have a number of speakers next week. It will be every day in advisory starting on Tuesday. That was 8th grade. 7th grade, you'll be participating in a program called Erica's Lighthouse. It is similar to what you did as 6th graders, but it is level 2. It's the next version of Erica's Lighthouse. So that will be during advisory for you next week as well. We're sending that information again to your families so they have that. But it will be a busy week next week. That takes us to this week's Funny Friday. Here come three great jokes. Two of them came from the Bob Evans Kids menu. That's how you know they're good ones. Here they come. Why do baby chickens love a good deal? Why do baby chickens love a good deal? Because they cheap, cheap, cheap. Okay, that one wasn't very good. Next one. What did the vegetable say to his date? What did the vegetable say to his date? Boy, you're a cutecumber. Oh, that's all I got. Last one. What did the ocean say to the beach? What did the ocean say to the beach? Nothing. It just waved. That's all I got. Hey, students and staff, let's make it a great day. Or not. The choice is yours.
How's it going, Jay? I'm Luke, and this is a military shout-out to the United States Air Force and Space Force. The United States Air Force was founded on September 18, 1947. It was created to defend the nation and its airspace against air threats in coordination with the Army, Navy, and Marines, and Space Force. Speaking of the Space Force was founded very recently on December 20th, 2019. It is probably less well known as the Air Force due to its recent addition to the military, but it is still very important nonetheless. It makes sure that space is secure and safe for the United States to launch rockets because space travel is still fairly new. The Air Force and the Space Force are still similar because the Space Force is affiliated with the Air Force, just like how the Marine Corps is affiliated with the Navy and how the Coast Guard is affiliated with the Army. Let me know if you guys have friends, family, or anybody you know to serve in the military. That is all from me, guys. Have a fantastic day, JA.
Hi, JA. It's Morgan with the News of the World. On Tuesday night, two Yankees fans got kicked out of the fourth game of the World Series after one of them tried to yank the baseball out of the glove and the glove off the hand of a Los Angeles Dodgers player, Mookie Betts. And these two fans were probably just trying to be funny, but ended up getting kicked out of the game. Hey, have a great day, Jay.
What is up, Jay? I'm Luke, and this is On This Day. November 8th, 1997 is when a star chef, Gordon Ramsay, came into the world. Gordon Ramsay is a celebrity chef and restaurant owner. He's the head chef of a British show called Hell's Kitchen. He is very, very famous for numerous dishes, such as his beef Wellington. He is also famous for his infamous line, "What are you? I am an idiot sandwich."
What are you?
An idiot sandwich.
What are you?
An idiot sandwich.
Man, he can also be a little intense. That's all from me. Have a good day, Jay.
Hi, Jay. It's Morgan with the vocab word of the day. The vocab word of the day is phantasmagoria. Phantasmagoria means dreamlike visions. If you ever had a high fever, you may have experienced a phantasmagoria of strange images in your half-awake feverish state.
I need to go check on Regan. She's a little sick. Hey, Regan, let me check your temperature. Oh my gosh, you're burning up!
Who are you?
You're burning up!
Who are you?
I'm Morgan.
Hi, Morgan. I haven't seen you in forever.
Regan, are you experiencing a phantasmagoria right now?
Have a great day, J.A.
Hello, Jonathan Otter Pioneers. It's Mrs. Conley. I'm back again for a book talk in hopefully under 60 seconds. The book I'm showcasing this week is called Paradise on Fire by Jewel Parker Rhodes. This is one of my favorite authors, and I'm going to talk about her newest book called Paradise on Fire. In this novel, Addie, our main character, is haunted by a tragic apartment fire that happened when she was just 4 years old. Years later, Addie is participating in a camp in California, and while she's there, there is a devastating forest fire, and Addie comes face to face with her past, and she has to figure out if she's strong enough to have the skills and trust to make it out of the forest alive. This book is inspired by a real-life campfire turned forest fire in California in 2018. It's a powerful read. Fans of Hatchet and anyone who loves survival stories will really enjoy this book. Come on down to the library and we'll get it checked out for you. And we also can get some copies for you from the Plain City Library. Thank you so much. Bye.
Hey, Jay, I'm Evan.
And I'm Drew.
And today we're going to be doing a three-point contest. There are going to be two people shooting threes for 30 seconds.
Whoever can shoot the most threes in that 30 seconds wins.
Your name?
Griffin.
And how many shots do you think you're going to make in 30 seconds?
Three.
I'm here with?
Nate.
And how many shots do you think you're going to make in 30 seconds?
Four.
What do you have to say about your win there?
I'm not that good at basketball, but I still won.
Solid.
So, Griffin, how do you feel about that loss?
I mean, he doesn't play basketball when I do. I should be ashamed.
I'm here with?
John.
And how many shots do you think you're going to make in 30 seconds?
30.
And your name is?
Evan Sweet.
How many shots are you making in 30 seconds?
Go for like 4 or 5.
So, Evan, what do you have to say about that win?
You know, I guess I just came ready to play, and best shooter in the CBC, you can say.